Welcome to this video on the role of ductility in design. Definition of the ductility is like this. Ductility is the ability of a structure or structure element to undergo large deformation without rupture. So if it is able to undergo large deformation, then it will not fail within that deformation, and that is why the system will be safe even with large displacement or deformation. Here we have shown a forced displacement curve. In the beginning the curve is straight line, then there is yielding starts here, and then the response is nonlinear, and finally it ruptures here. So the displacement at which it is yielding is the yield displacement delta y, and the displacement at which it is rupturing, the maximum displacement, also sometimes given as ultimate displacement, delta u or delta m. Now the displacement in between this delta y and delta m is the delta p, the plastic deformation, plastic displacement. So this part, this plastic displacement, is imparting about the ductility in the system. A expression for ductility is mu equal to delta m by delta y. This is also called ductility index mu. Since we have considered displacement as the parameter here in this figure, so this ductility that we arrived at, delta m by delta y, is called displacement ductility and given by mu delta. Now what is the minimum ductility? You can have an idea from the expression we have just seen. So ductility is mu equal to delta m by delta y equal to delta y plus delta p divided by delta y, that is this equal to delta p and plus delta y. So delta y getting cancelled, we get delta mu equal to 1 plus delta p divided by delta y. So when is the minimum ductility occurs? Minimum ductility occurs when delta p is 0. In that case, mu equal to 1. Now what is the physical meaning of delta p equal to 0? Physical meaning is, means there is no plasticity in the system. So when there is no plasticity in the system is actually elastic. So minimum value of the ductility is 1, and it is indicating actually an elastic system. Now as we have discussed earlier, the displacement ductility is given by this. Taken it back because we shall see that there can be other kinds of ductilities based on the parameters that you take along the force axis and the displacement axis. So next is our rotational ductility. When the force parameter is moment taken on the vertical axis, we have the rotation on the horizontal axis, the response. So we have the rotational ductility here in the similar way. The rotational yield rotation is delta y, and maximum rotation is delta t. On the vertical axis we have the moment, and horizontal axis we have the rotation. So at the yielding, the rotation is theta y, and at maximum rupture point the rotation is theta m. So in between we have the plastic rotation theta p. So rotational ductility equal to theta m by theta y equal to 1 plus theta p by theta y. In Feynman documents, most of the responses are given in terms of moment and rotation. And based on that, the performance levels of the elements are defined, like immediate occupancy, etc., etc. Now we can have also strain ductility if we put on the vertical axis stress and horizontal axis strain. So in this similar way, the mu epsilon, the strain ductility, is equal to epsilon m by epsilon y equal to 1 plus epsilon p by epsilon y. Epsilon p is the plastic strain. And further we can go for curvature ductility. Curvature ductility is mu phi, expressed by mu phi, maximum curvature divided by yield curvature. So here we have this plastic curvature here, phi p. Though most of the courses have given their response reduction factor in terms of displacement ductility, mu delta, but in most of our structural mechanics and the earthquake engineering related topics, we shall be seeing that the curvature ductility is of greater importance in the discussion. So we have the yield curvature phi y and maximum rupture curvature phi m, and phi p is the plastic curvature. If you take the magnitude of the different types of curvature we have considered, the magnitude of mu phi curvature ductility is highest, then epsilon ductility, this strain ductility, then rotational ductility, and lowest is the displacement ductility. Now it does not mean that the curvature ductility, if you take, you are going to get a higher ductility of the system. It is not like that. It is the same ductility which are expressed through various names actually, and these are having the symbols like this, and in that expressions, the magnitude wise, their positions are like this. In seismic design, we have seen in our previous slide that code takes R, which is equal to actually mu delta. Now, this curvature ductility can be expressed in terms of the neutral axis depth for RC sections. So, we have taken a simply supported beam here, and the deflected curve, the elastic curve, is shown here by dotted line. At some distance x, the deflection is vertical, transverse deflection is y. So in that case, we know the curvature is given by d2y dx square, because the slope of this curve is dy dx, and the differential of the slope is actually curvature, or change of rate of slope is curvature. So d2y dx square equal curvature, and we express this by the symbol phi. Now we have the flexural equation m equal to ei d2y dx square. This is established to have got in the structural mechanics. So rearranging this and writing this d2y dx square equal to phi, we can write m equal to ei phi. So this gives phi equal to m by ei. So let us give this equation number as 1 and start with the equation number phi equal to m by ei. We have considered one RC section of certain size B and D. The neutral axis depth from the top is x, and the effective depth to the center of the steel is small d. The strain in the concrete at the top, compression strain, is epsilon c. So with this, we get this expression in equation 1. Let us divide the numerator and denominator by x, the neutral axis depth. So I get this phi equal to m by x, at the bottom ei by x. So rearranging this, I take e and I by x inside, because I by x is nothing but z, the modulus section. So I can write phi equal to m by x divided by e z. Now we shall further rearrange this. I shall take m by z first and 1 by x, and m by z, you know, is nothing but stress. So I can write sigma. So it is sigma divided by sigma multiplied by 1 by x. And I will take now sigma by e 1 by x. Sigma by e is nothing but the strain. So we can write now final expression phi equal to epsilon c by x. So what is the utility of this knowledge? We shall see that while getting the moment curvature diagram, this relationship can be utilized to get the moment curvature diagram. So here is the moment curvature diagram. It is a representation between the moment and induced curvature. The moment will induce a curvature, so that curvature, moment curvature relationship. So in the beginning it is elastic and it is responding linearly, then it is yielding here, then upper yield, lower yield, etc., then gradually non-linear, and finally it is rupturing at this point. At the rupture point, you have the maximum curvature, which is given by phi m or phi u. So this is the normal moment curvature diagram. You can bilinearize this by considering the energy dissipated and following some rules available. So in that case, you can get a bilinearized moment curvature diagram. Let us see what is this. This is one. So it goes in a straight line, then it becomes fully plastic and it ruptures here. So this is actually idealized representation of the real picture on the left side. So here it is very easy to get your yield curvature, which is the intersection of these two lines. So yield curvature you can find out, and maximum curvature is already available. So in between you have here to here the plastic curvature, and while drawing this diagram, moment curvature diagram, what we do, we can apply a moment in this section, and for that moment there will be some computable depth of neutral axis which will produce some strain in the concrete, epsilon c at the top, and the curvature will be given by epsilon c by x. So say this is a point here in the curve, so we have the corresponding moment here and corresponding curvature I get from this equation epsilon c by x. So getting so many points, I can now finally plot the moment curvature diagram applying this relationship, and then I can bilinearize this to get the yield curvature, and ultimate curvature is generally known by some standard expression, or you can get it from the experimental results where you have the maximum value of the curvature here. Now you have a structure, you want the structure to be ductile. So how do you impart ductility? Ductility cannot be imparted through any design, no mechanics, but it is imparted through detailing. So there are various courses available in different countries for the ductile detailing. In India, the IS 13920 is for RC ductile detailing, and SP6 for steel ductile detailing. So if you follow this, then your structure will be ductile structure and conforming to the code. So some important relationship we shall see between these parameters we have discussed. If you take curvature and multiply it by a length, then you get rotation. This is from simple understanding of the meaning of curvature and meaning of rotation. So if we take the plastic curvature and divide it by plastic hinge length, this we shall discuss in some other video, what is plastic hinge length, then you get the plastic rotation theta p. Similarly, you have, if you multiply length with rotation, then you get displacement. So if you take the plastic hinge length and multiply it by the plastic curvature, you get the plastic displacement delta p. This is very simple, it can be illustrated through this diagram here. We have taken say a column of height h, and it is undergoing a rotation theta at the base, then the displacement it is suffering is simply given by theta equal to delta equal to theta into h. So that is what is written here, delta p equal to lp phi p. Phi p is plastic curvature and lp is the plastic hinge length. We shall have more discussion on this in some other new video. So phi p equal to phi m minus phi y. How to get plastic curvature? Plastic curvature cannot be obtained from any formula, but you have to obtain it from the maximum value minus the yield value. Similarly, displacement wise also, plastic displacement is maximum displacement minus yield displacement. Now, in literature, you have the standard expression for the phi y. Phi y, standard expressions are there depending on whether it is beam section or column section, circular section or rectangular section. So phi y is available. And phi m is generally guided by the material properties. So that is also standard expression available. So from there you get the value of the plastic curvature phi p or plastic displacement delta p. Let us see a simple application of this concept in a bridge column. So we have considered a bridge column of height h from the center of the deck to the base here. The height is h. So plastic displacement is maximum displacement minus delta y, and delta y equal to phi y a square by 3. This standard expression is available. How it came? If you take phi y into h by 3, then you get what is corresponding theta y, the yield rotation. So yield rotation into h will give the displacement, which is the yield displacement here. So that is the background of this expression. And delta p equal to phi p lp into h. Phi p lp gives you theta p, the plastic rotation. So you multiply by a distance height, you get the displacement at the top of the spire, which is the plastic displacement delta p. Now we are interested in calculating the displacement ductility mu delta, and the expression is the delta m by delta y, which is 1 plus delta p by delta y, we have already seen. The delta p is available from this expression and delta y available from this expression. So if you set all this together, we simply get this final expression of mu delta equal to 1 plus 3 phi p lp divided by phi y h. So lp for column, the plastic hinge length standard expressions are available. Researchers have found it out from experiments. And phi p equal to phi m minus phi y. And phi y, how do we get? Phi y standard expressions are available for various sections. So setting all these parameters, you can get the displacement ductility mu delta for this bridge pier. So let us make a summary of what we have seen. Ductility is the ability of structure or structure element to sustain large deformation without fracture. Ductile structure fail gradually and the occupants can evacuate in emergency, they have the sufficient time. Also, ductile structure will give you some warning before failing. It will not fail in a brittle manner suddenly. Ductile structure show large energy dissipation in earthquake. During earthquake, your structure will absorb energy from the earthquake, and this energy must be dissipated in some way. That is why the structure actually breaks, it gets damaged. So if your system is ductile, then it will be undergoing large deformation, and through the deformation it will form a hysteresis loop, and through each loop it will dissipate energy in every cycle of vibration. So that's why we require ductile structure to dissipate energy. Ductility in structure is imparted through proper detailing, and detailing courses are available in all countries. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe the channel, like, comment and share the video. You can put your queries in this comment box. I will be glad to answer your queries. Thank you very much and wish to see you again in the next video.